Hi everyone, this is Ross from GG Circuit, and today I'll be covering the point of sale system from a gamer's perspective within the ggLeap client. If a gamer logs into the PC and they don't have a valid Game Pass on their account, then they will be able to log in, but they will not be able to proceed any further until they have resolved that issue. So either they can purchase one of the Game Passes that you've made available on the web administrator, or if they have enough coins that they've collected from their previous gameplay, then they can redeem a Game Pass. Again, these are Game Passes that you have configured at a price that you've decided to suit your economy. When it comes to selecting a Game Pass, the users can click on the Game Pass to find out more information. So this is a simple 2 hours unrestricted Game Pass. This is one that actually has restrictions. So if the gamer purchases this Game Pass and the current time is not between 11 and 3, the Game Pass will stay on their account, but they will not be logged into the PC until that Game Pass is valid during that period of time. And similarly, the Day Pass is valid for 12 hours, but it also expires at 11:59. So if the gamer were to purchase this at 5 p.m., they would still be able to play until 11:59, but then the Game Pass expires and cannot be used again. Same for the Night Pass. So for this demonstration, I'm going to purchase a 4-hour Game Pass, and you'll notice it has a coin bonus symbol. If I just actually click on that first to see that this will award 500 coins simply for purchasing this Game Pass. When I get to the checkout screen, there are 4 available options. These will need to be mostly configured on the web administrator as well. But if a gamer has a balance on their account, so it is possible for gamers to deposit money to their account and then spend from that balance, then we can pay for this Game Pass from the account balance. If you wish to allow users to start a post-pay session with a predefined credit limit, so for example, the credit limit in my venue is $25, so I cannot spend more than that as a post-pay session. The post-pay functionality and credit limits can be determined on a per-user basis or on a per-user group basis. So you may have VIP users, for example, that can have a higher credit limit. We can also pay directly with a phone, which will present a QR code for the user to scan. And we can also choose the option to summon a human, which will notify a member of staff to come and collect payment from the user. So for this example, I'm just, for simplicity, going to pay from my account balance. Which will log me into the ggLeap client, and now I have the time remaining on my account. If I navigate to the full point of sale system in the shop, I can see those same Game Passes, plus any snacks or drinks that have been configured as well. So you're able to create categories and subcategories and display your inventory within the point of sale system. We can then add items to the cart. And make adjustments here. And check out those items in the same way as before. In this case, I'll summon a human. And we can see now that we have an extra symbol here to say that the order is being prepared. I will also demonstrate how a post-pay order can work if you've enabled this functionality. So a user can add some items to the cart, check out, and choose pay later. Because some of these items need to be physically delivered, the member of staff has been notified these items will be delivered. And once delivered, which I have just completed from the web administrator, then this now finalizes the current bill. So we can continue to add to this bill if we're remaining underneath the total credit limit that's available. And when it comes time to complete and finish the session, the user can either click on this button to complete the payment, or if they simply attempt to log out, they'll be reminded that they have an outstanding bill. They can either pay that from the account balance, they can pay that with their phone, or they can simply log out. This will send an alert to the web administrator, to the member of staff, notifying them that a payment is due to be collected. And that's what I'll do in this instance. Okay, so that's the end of this short video summary on the ggLeap point of sale system from the gamer's perspective. Please feel free to leave any comments or suggestions below, and I'll see you on the next video.